Hello students, this is Nishanti from Pond Vidyashram Group of Schools. Hope you are doing good. Stay home, stay safe. Okay, this is your chapter 1 in physics, physical world. Let me start this lesson. Our earth has an amazing variety of materials, life and behavior. It always invoked human mind to observe the physical environment carefully. Look for any meaningful patterns and relations in natural phenomena and use new tools to interact with nature. As time passed, this endeavor of human mind gave birth to modern science and technology. These are the contents in this lesson: science and its origin, natural sciences, impact and uses of physics, scope of physics, factors responsible for progress of physics, hypothesis, axiom and models, technological applications of physics, fundamental forces in nature, conserved quantities, conservation laws. Okay, let us see about what is science and its origin. Okay, the word science is derived from the Latin verb scientia, meaning to know. Okay, and science is a systematic understanding of natural phenomena in detail so that it can be predicted, controlled, and modified. Science involves exploring, experimenting, and speculating phenomena happening around us. So this scientific method is a way to gain knowledge in a systematic and in-depth way. So these are all the steps. Let us see. So this scientific method, it has the following steps: systematic observation, controlled experiments, qualitative and quantitative reasoning, mathematical modeling, prediction and verification or falsification of theories, speculation or prediction. Natural science is a branch of science concerned with the description, prediction, and understanding of natural phenomena based on the observational and empirical evidence. Science is ever dynamic. There is no final theory in science and no unquestioned authority among scientists. As observation improves in detail and precision or experiments yield new results, theories must account for them if necessary by introducing modifications. Okay, this natural science consists of the following discipline, you know very well: physics, chemistry and biology. Physics is the basic discipline in the category of natural science. Physics is a study of basic laws of nature and their manifestation in different natural phenomena. Physics is the study of physical world and matter and its motion through space and time, along with related concepts such as energy and force. And the word physics is derived from the Greek word meaning nature. There are two principal approaches in physics: unification and reduction. We'll see. Unification. In physics, we try to explain diverse physical phenomena in terms of a few concepts and laws. This approach is called unification in physics. For example, same law of gravitation is used to explain the motion of moon around the earth, motion of planets around the sun, and falling of apple on the ground. Also, the basic laws of electromagnetism govern all electric and magnetic phenomena. And the next principle is reduction. In physics, we also try to derive the properties of the bigger and complicated system from a properties and interaction of its constituent simpler parts. This approach is called reduction in physics. For example, physical quantities like temperature and internal energy are used to deal with bulk system in thermodynamics. Similarly, molecular constituents of bulk system are used in kinetic energy and statistical mechanics. Impact and uses of physics. It can explain a phenomena, all the natural phenomena happening over the large magnitude with a simple theory. Experiments and observations are used to develop new theories for unidentified phenomena and improve old theories for existing phenomena. So it is developing new theories and it improves old theories also. And the third use is development of devices using laws of physics. Scope of physics. Physics has a huge scope as it covers a tremendous range, magnitude of various physical quantities such as length, mass, time, energy, etc. It deals with very large magnitude of astronomical phenomena as well as very small magnitude involving electrons, photons, etc. We'll see the range here. So length covers 10 to the power 40 meters or more, and as low as 10 to the power minus 14 meters or less. So where we are using this 10 to the power 40 to study astronomical values. 10 to the power minus 14 or less in case of study of electrons, protons, etc. Okay. Similarly, the range of time scales goes from 10 to the power minus 22 seconds to 10 to the power 18 seconds, and mass from 10 to the power minus 30 kg to 10 to the power 55 kg. So physics is broadly divided into two types based on its scope. One is classical physics and another is modern physics. Classical physics deals with macroscopic phenomena, while modern physics deals with microscopic phenomena. We'll see in detail about macroscopic and microscopic phenomena. Study this ranges, length range, time range and mass range. Very important. Macroscopic group of physics consists of phenomena at laboratory, terrestrial and astronomical scales, that is large scales. Macroscopic means large scales. It includes the following subjects: mechanics, electrodynamics, optics, thermodynamics. We'll see about mechanics now. It is based on the Newton's law on motion and laws of gravitation. It's concerned with motion or equilibrium of particles, rigid and deformable bodies, and general system of particles. Examples: propulsion of rocket by ejecting gases, water or sound waves, equilibrium of bent rod under a load. Next, electrodynamics. It deals with electric and magnetic phenomena associated with charged and magnetic bodies. Examples: a motion of current carrying conductor in a magnetic field, the response of a circuit to an AC voltage, the propagated of radio waves in the ionosphere. And third subject is optics. It deals with phenomena involving light. Examples: reflection and refraction of light, dispersion of light through prism, color exhibited by thin films. And fourth subject, thermodynamics. It deals with systems in macroscopic equilibrium and changes in internal energy, temperature, entropy, etc. of systems under applications of external force or heat. Examples: efficiency of heat engines, direction of physical and chemical process. So this is nothing but thermodynamics deals with the study of the system in the macroscopic equilibrium, considering changes in internal energy, temperature, entropy. Next we see about microscopic group of physics. Microscopic group of physics deals with the study of constitution and structure of matter at every minute scale of length, that is at the scale of atoms and nuclei or even smaller than this. This group of physics can be studied under the subject called quantum physics. And there is one more group of physics called mesoscopic physics. This is a new group. An intermediate group of physics, namely mesoscopic physics, has recently came into existence. This group deals with the study of materials of an intermediate length scale, that is a few tens or hundreds of atoms. A small recap of this video. I said science is systematic attempt to understand the natural phenomena, and this attempt involves 5 steps: systematic observation, controlled experiment, qualitative and quantitative reasoning, mathematical modeling, prediction and verification or falsification of theories. Okay, and I said physics. What is physics? Physics is a study of physical world, study of basic laws of nature and their manifestation in natural phenomena. And this physics, it has 2 principles: unification and reduction. And we saw scope of physics. Under this, I said 3 important scopes: macroscopic, that is large scale, microscopic and mesoscopic physics. Microscopic is nothing but studying under very small range, I mean the scale of atoms, nuclei, and even smaller than this. And mesoscopic physics is intermediate between macroscopic and microscopic. Hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you.